Hi, I'm Torben Janssen from thoughtsonjava.org with the new Hibernate tip. I was asked for the fastest option to delete a bunch of database records. So here it is. JPA and Hibernate provide two general options to remove entities. The most common one is the remove method of the entity manager. It is easy to use, but also very inefficient if you need to remove a list of entities. For each of the entities you want to delete, Hibernate has to load the entity, perform the lifecycle transition to the state removed, and trigger the SQL delete operation. That requires at least one query to load all entities and an additional SQL delete statement for each of them. So, when you use this approach to remove 100 entities, Hibernate has to perform at least 101 SQL statements. It's often better to remove such a list of entities with a JPQL query. Similar to SQL, you can define a JPQL delete operation that removes all entities with just one statement. Let's take a look. Here you can see a JPQL query that removes all author entities with an ID included in this list. But be careful, this approach has a drawback. Hibernate doesn't load the entities and doesn't perform the lifecycle state transition to removed. That provides substantial performance benefits, but it also prevents Hibernate from updating its caches, including the first level cache, and from triggering any lifecycle events or listeners. You should always call the flush and clear method on your entity manager to detach all entities from the current persistence context and to clear the first level cache before you perform a JPQL update or delete statement. I get into more details on that in my Hibernate tip video, how to detach an entity from the persistence context. I'll add a link to it to the video description. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free Thoughts on Java library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like an ebook about the Java 8 support in Hibernate, a printable PDF version of this Hibernate tip, lots of cheat sheets, and a video course. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. See you next week for a new Hibernate tip, and if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!